some of the further research that we're conducting through the International Center for the Study of Planned Events includes a wide range of projects. Doctors Rebecca Finkel and Kathy Matheson have just returned from Vancouver, British Columbia, where they've been studying the relationship between human rights and mega events at the Winter Olympic Games. Claire Seaman and myself examined the happiness factor at the major events of Homecoming, The Gathering. Majella Sweeney, Dr. Sweeney, and I have recently had the privilege of working with the East Lothian Council to provide evidence of the success of their Homecoming events. And Dr. Finkel, Kwan Nguyen Lin, and myself have investigated sustainable funding for Edinburgh and Glasgow cultural events. And finally, two PhD students and myself have been looking at alternative festival financing schemes beyond the public purse. I'm just going to share a snapshot of some of this research with you tonight. First, The Gathering. As you all know, financially, there were significant challenges. But we didn't study the financials of The Gathering. We studied what we called the happiness factor. We employed 15 student researchers over 2 days, 210 days of observing 46,000 spectators. They conducted 150 long-form semi-structured interviews with 1,000 photographs. They took ethnophotography of the various persons and activities. And here's what we discovered. Ranging from the pageant at the Castle Esplanade to the events in Holyrood Park, they did counts using actual counters to determine at the start of an event, at the end of an event, how much attrition, how much slippage there was to determine which events had the ability to hold their audience. So this evidence may help other similar events. And then they observed the various people in terms of the smile factors, body language, applause levels, and so on, and measured these factors at the various events. And then they interviewed them, and of course they asked, what was your perception before attending this event, and what is your perception following? And as you can see, it was significantly higher after attending The Gathering for 1 or 2 days. And then they observed the involvement, the engagement of the spectators by individual activity. Were they just sitting there or were they engaged in some physical way? And this shows you, based upon the various events that we studied, which had a higher engagement, which again may be helpful to other similar events. So we found that there was a positive correlation between event behaviors, visitor satisfaction, and the memories people take from events. And the use of ethnophotography, interviews, and observation provides a more comprehensive profile of the overall visitor experience. And then, as I said, Dr. Sweeney and I had the privilege of working with the East Lothian Council to look at 16 events that took place between May and November, 5 ethnographic studies, 12 student researchers worked with us conducting surveys at the finale event, the Saltire, and we received 374 usable surveys from these 16 events. When we asked, do you think this event has promoted an understanding of Scottish culture and heritage, which is one of the key government objectives of Homecoming, a whopping almost 90% said yes. We asked, as a result of this event, will you come back to East Lothian in the future? And again, nearly 94% yes. And where did they stay? Well, whilst the majority may have... Whilst the majority may have been day visitors, a significant number stayed for three or more nights in the destination. When we asked where did you stay, and once again, while a large percentage stayed in their own home because they were local residents, a significant percentage stayed at various other accommodations, including bed and breakfast, caravan parks, full-service hotels, etc. Then we asked, what were your perceptions before and after of East Lothian as a tourism destination? And look at this significant increase in the positive, high perception of East Lothian. And of course, about 28% of the people who came out with of Scotland, which beat all the indicators for other events within Scotland at this time. So what are our conclusions? Well, that the event portfolio of East Lothian has strong potential for future development. We encourage that. That international visitors should be targeted for future East Lothian events, and that East Lothian has a future potential for the development of events linked to Scottish culture and history, as evidenced by the responses from these visitors.